Tourism is another segment of our economy seeking to rebound from the pandemic and grow. And the state's Secretary of Tourism, Lieutenant Governor Matt Pinnell, says he could do that if his budget would grow a bit. Pinnell says it would allow him to advertise more and target international travelers. You currently have a $5 million cap. What would you like? And if you could get it, how would you spend that money?
If we could raise that cap between $7 and $9 million, that gives me the ability to have an international marketing campaign. Texas spends over $10 million just on international budget. They have a $40 million tourism budget. But if I was in the $7 to $1 million range, I could do an advertising campaign in Australia, which is our fastest growing international tourism market, is Australians, because they love Route 66 and they love our Native American history. Japan, the Japanese, is the second largest international tourism market into the United States and one of the fastest growing markets right here in Oklahoma. If you don't invite people to Oklahoma, then they're not going to show up.
Have you given consideration to getting the superstars, the Garths, the Rebas, the Careys, the Blakes, all together in a commercial to help promote their home state?
Yeah, Rich, I'm glad you brought this up. So one of the things that we're working on is a relaunch of the Oklahoma Music Trail. I'm not ready to show renderings of what we're working on yet, but I hope within the next few months we are kind of creating this top 40 hit list across the state of Oklahoma. So people know exactly where they need to go in Carrie Underwood's hometown, exactly where they should be going to see Blake Shelton and Garth and Hanson and everything in between. We've got to be promoting this because it's one of the greatest tourism assets that we have is our musical heritage that we have here in Oklahoma.
Lieutenant Governor, before we get to Labor Day specifically, how has the summer been for tourism in Oklahoma?
Yeah, you know, we actually had a really good summer here, kind of coming out of kind of the peak time of last winter when we were dealing with COVID. We had 3 million more people visit our state park system in 2020 versus 2019. Now, some of that was due to, yes, people getting outdoors, wanting to social distance. And so now the plan and really the vision that we have for our tourism department is to sustain that growth.
As you mentioned, COVID has actually had both good and bad impacts on tourism, hasn't it?
Certainly our lodges had to be shut down. Our trail systems were open, of course, but you know, a lot of our museums were shut down. That's why we were really pushing Route 66 travelers, which again, we had an increase in Route 66 travelers. But the international market was really shut down.
So how about Labor Day? Have you got any early numbers, any sense that Oklahomans and others got out and took advantage of what Oklahoma has to offer?
Yeah, we had over 12,000 rooms booked at our lodges across our state park system over Labor Day weekend. That's very good numbers for us. If we start turning a corner again, the Delta variant and other variants that will have more Oklahomans and tourists from other states visiting Oklahoma in very large numbers in the fall and the winter, because it's really prime time for us.
Lieutenant Governor, if you would, give me one facility, one attraction that's either open or about to open that is particularly excites you and is going to be a boost.
There's one big one that is opening up here very soon that is at the top of my list, and that is the First Americans Museum, which is going to be world class. It is Smithsonian level good museum. And the Chickasaw Nation is planning on building around that museum as well. That is gonna be one of the top tourism destinations in the state of Oklahoma, right smack dab in the heart of Oklahoma City. So the First Americans Museum, you gotta go. It's a bucket list type of spot.
Lieutenant Governor Matt Pinnell, thank you so much for your time today.
Oh, thank you so much for having me.